Okay.
Thought they felt stabbing or whatever. Is that you?
Yeah.
The hell was that?
I was making sound effects, man.
You were rad up in here. Street level floor, and then you got the upper floor where the actual residents of the house lived. We're heading into the parlor room.
Quite a few guests have captured apparitions in these rooms, full-bodied apparitions and photographs. Notably, I've received more images that were captured on site looking into the reflections of the gentleman's mirror and the lady's mirror than I have in any other general part of the rooms. Each time something is captured in this mirror, it's over here in this area. And there is a photograph we have that we witnessed it being captured. It was captured in the middle of the tour on a digital camera. And there is a young woman standing back here with her head facing the back of the gentleman taking the picture in the mirror. He thought he was alone in this room. He was what we call the straggler, the person that sticks around longer than everyone else to get that last picture. The tour guide was standing just right back here, encouraging this man to hurry it along. He'd already checked this room. He knew there was only one gentleman left. The gentleman believed he was alone. But when he snaps the photograph, he immediately realizes that in his photograph, there's a young woman standing right here. And the look on her face itself, is terrifying. It's very concerning.
But the same. Now, the mirrors, I'm going to think, are matrixing. I mean, when I hear mirrors.
I mean, if you get.
Right. Look at the side of it though. Put your.
Even if you get it right up on it.
I mean, oh wow! Y'all look really cool as hell in that mirror. I mean, your eyes look black, Becca.
Awesome.
And Donald's mouth looks black right there. But I mean, you're gonna get matrixing. I mean, the older the mirror. Depending on what it's made out of.
I know. It starts
tarnishing, yeah. Basically. And you're going to look over here. I noticed something over here was earlier. If you shine your light, you can probably see. Yeah, I guess you can't see it with the light shining directly on it. You can see a lot of. Yeah. Yeah, and it's 32.
These days, for the first 10 years that the homeowner lived in this house after restoring Sorrel Weed Mansion, almost on a nightly basis, they were hearing the sounds of parties, big parties, echoing down here. Now, that sounds silly, but I'm going to tell you that we hear it even today. And it's not just voices, it's full conversations. It is very old music playing in the distance. It doesn't sound like it's coming from next door, but it doesn't sound like it's in the room next to you either. It's just there, somewhere in between. We hear crystal being chimed on, followed by laughter, constantly. We can hear two women chit-chatting throughout the afternoon, and it sounds as if it's coming from the ladies' parlor, even though there is nobody in the ladies' parlor. And we're hearing these voices. We've heard a lot of growls coming from that room as well. And there was an incident in between these two pocket doors here where myself and another investigator one night, we were doing an investigation here. We had some guests in these rooms. And they got very, very uncomfortable. And they were doing an EVP session. They had their K2 meters. The K2 meter started to spike, and they started feeling what they described as just not very well. They got a little nervous, and they raced downstairs. The investigator and I, we came up here, and we've investigated together for a lot of years. Now, he walks in between those doors, and it is freezing cold. in the drawing room, and it is muggy and hot here in the gentleman's parlor. And when he gets in between those doors, he literally falls to his knees, crumpled. He's got the most terrible pain in his stomach, and it just brings him to his knees. And I said, oh, come on, Gordon, you're exaggerating. But I know this gentleman. We've investigated for a long time. He's not the type to exaggerate. So when I moved towards him to extend my hand and help him get up, when I stood in between the pocket doors, I got the same feeling as if something had just reached into my stomach and squeezed very badly. And I sort of hunched over, grabbing my gut. And we both felt very, very not well, I guess you could say. And it wasn't until we got out of the room that everything about us went back to normal. And that was only about a month ago that happened. And I've been on this property for 3 years. I've never experienced anything like that. And in all my years investigating, I've never experienced anything like that. I've been around others.
Bill, Ronald, Becca, we are in the parlor, the gentleman's parlor. Is there anybody here in the home with us? Sorry, that's my foot. Mm-hmm. No, just sit off. Don't wear Converse.
So just have to get some more equipment out. We can't settle in, do we?
No.
K2, Ovulus.
I'm going in the other room. This is what?
The ladies' room? Or?
That's the ladies' parlor.
Ladies' parlor. And I'm told if you go in here, if they don't like you, they'll let you know.
The long-haired white boy.
Up in the room with all the ladies.
What?
8, begin, and warm.
Warm or worn?
Warm. W-A-R-M. Warm.
Yes, it's warm. Hey, ladies. My name is Joel. Sir, ambassador here.
Panel informed forever.
What was the first word?
The very, very first word?
No, the slash three.
Panel.
Panel.
P-A-N-A-L. P-A-N-E-L. Panel.
Outside radio noise.
Yeah. Car driving by.
Walking.
How many people are in the parlor right now?
Do you hear that?
I did. It sounded like that door creaking.
I did. Can you show yourself in the mirror? Or behind me?
I heard that y'all like big, elaborate parties.
We like parties too.
That's me, baby.
Hear something?
Becca said she was moving.
talking outside. If there's anybody here, let us know by making a noise. Can you tap on a wall or bang on a wall? I'll walk around with K2 a little bit.
Spock, will you know? See if they may.
See if the ladies may not like you. They didn't miss me. Charlie, you gotta have an opinion on that. That's a dull walking.
I'm stunk.
You gonna say get out?
Get out.
Okay, we're gonna set this green lighted thing here.
Where's the K2 at? Right there. Right there. This is supposed to be the corner with it. I'm curious.
Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi that I was talking about?
Oh, yeah.
We're not getting anything over here.
That's where it's supposed to be?
Yeah. We travel all this way for y'all to be wimps on us. Moon River gave us more than y'all got.
Heard y'all were pretty active last night.
Y'all had this rep. You can't live up to it for us.
Yeah, we've heard reports of.
Hear that?
I did. It was pink. It was right outside.
Things like pink a bit much.
I'm walking.
Oh.
What?
Y'all don't hear that voice? No shit. It sounded like it came from the hallway right there. And the door shut.
I'm hearing footsteps outside. Like in the hallway.
You hear?
I hear footsteps.
Ain't no doubt I heard voices then.
It's me.
Because I thought Nick and them were coming up. Answer them what they are.
radio?
I do.
Hello?
I swear I'm not lying in one bit.
I'm not lying. I just heard footsteps all up and down that thing.
Are y'all still outside? Nick? Is this thing Gordon? Nick, can you hear me? I heard voices. I heard male voices. I cannot tell what it said. Nick, can you hear me? What's that?
Alright, I'm talking on the scope right now, the periscope. Gabby, did you hear any male voices or footsteps? Dolce has heard some males talking.
And it wasn't just like
yes, they heard the footsteps.
Okay.
Awesome. Thanks, Tony. Thank you.
I'm talking about heard the footsteps.
Awesome. There's no doubt that his voice is wrong for that though, right back there. No doubt.
What time is it, Gabby? That's outside.
That, yeah. I'm wondering if what I heard might not be outside.
But I didn't hear voices over here.
So three.
Am I said that?
Yeah. I never heard the voices. I just heard footsteps.
It
sounded like it came from back that way and walked.
It's 3:30 here. So
that's where I heard it from.
So at 3:25.
I heard footsteps walking from that way to the front door.
Okay, and what I heard was back that way.
We're in the parlor.
Right before the footsteps, the footsteps started. Right?
I got six people in there.
You six people are awesome.
Yeah, everybody else is not.
I'm just going back over here.
3:32, thank you. Give me a timestamp for,
We got a
video recording there. We got two recorders plus a scope. Just set the REM pod outside the hallway. We've got a REM pod out in the hallway. Ain't nothing else going on.
Okay. I hope we pick up voices on that.
Picking up recorder.
Yeah.
Ibid hop forever. It's a new word.
Where do you want to?
Ibid hop. That was me.
Is there anybody here in this house that would like to communicate with us? We're here to find out your story, to find out history behind this house. We understand that there are soldiers.
Hey, y'all got a radio?
Buried underneath this house.
Everybody answer. We heard big time male voices up here. I'm standing in the ladies' parlor. I heard almost a conversation. I cannot tell what was said. And soon as I heard that, they heard footsteps go from where I heard from down the hallway. And our live viewers heard. And so that's what I want to make sure that wasn't y'all. There's no doubt I heard no voices in that hallway. That's why I was checking to make sure with y'all, you know. Okay, well, we can rule that out. I just want to check with you, brother. I mean, take care.
What did I say?
He's in his office.
Okay.
He's not even with Gordon. Gordon's by himself. So Gordon went talking to himself. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That was Mr. Sorrell, if that was you in the hallway.
Anyone.
Or anyone for that matter. Anybody walk in the hallway.
I heard you.
Walk back through the hallway. There's a device in there on the floor. Won't you go pick it up for me? Or move it so nobody steps on it.
So we did mark it when I heard it, right?
Yeah, I got a time on it. It's like 2:25-ish. Sometime between 2:25 and 2:30.
How long do y'all want to go with
that? Huh?
How long do y'all want to go?
It's 3:30 right now here, isn't it?
I'm not sure.
We're going to gain an hour going back.
Yeah. I'm going to take you up on that offer and drive it, bro.
Oh, I will.
Moving?
Doyle did a little bit.
Okay. I did. I'm sorry.
Are there any spirits located in here? If there are, please make your presence known.
Ms. Sorrell, how did you feel about finding your husband in the arms of a slave? Why would you do such a thing as to take your own life by jumping off the balcony? Leaving children behind, leaving your kids behind, maybe even grown up, but still, at the same time, they're your children, they're your kids. Kind of selfish, if you ask me. There's basically a tree growing right where you died. You know, make some kind of contact with us. We're gonna move on.
Next.
Do what?
Say next.
Next. Yeah. All right. We're gonna move on out of here and go somewhere else. And y'all don't want to cooperate.